Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's one way you can keep me going, inspired and refreshed. Now if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also please don't forget to subscribe. Problem 90. Oil of specific gravity 0.86 discharges from a 250 mm diameter pipe through a 100 mm diameter orifice at the end of the pipe. An open manometer containing mercury is attached into the pipe wall before the orifice and the deflection of mercury is 290 mm. The oil and mercury interface is 0.9 meter below the center of pipe. Laboratory records show that coefficient of velocity is 0.98 and coefficient of contraction 0.63 for this orifice. Determine the discharge of oil in the pipe, the diameter of the jet at the vena contracta, and the velocity of oil in the jet. So for the solution, let's have the figure to help us analyze the problem. So this is now the situation, and let's call this is mercury, deflection, this is 0.9 to 50 mm. Then we have oil of specific gravity 0.86. Let's call the point here as 0.1 and the point here as 0.2, where we set up energy equation to solve for the theoretical velocity. Then hopefully then after that, the actual discharge, which is coefficient of discharge times area O square root of 2gh. But let's use the basic formula. Actual discharge equals coefficient of discharge times theoretical discharge. The theoretical discharge can be determined from the theoretical velocity by setting up or writing energy equation between points 1 and 2, ignoring losses. So velocity head at 1 plus pressure head at 1 in terms of oil plus g sub 1 equals velocity head at 0.2 plus pressure head at 0.2 plus elevation head at 0.2. Of course, the datum is selected at 1, but the elevation head at 1 is equal to that of the elevation head at 2, which is 0. So both of these will be 0, as well as the pressure head at 0.2 because it is exposed to the atmosphere. So velocity head at 1 plus pressure head at 1 in terms of oil plus 0 equals velocity head at 0.2 plus 0 plus 0. Simplifying, velocity pressure head at 1 is equal to velocity head at 0.2 minus velocity head at 0.1. Then next, we apply continuity equation. Q sub 1 equals Q sub 2, pi over 4 diameter 1 square times V1 equals pi over 4 diameter 2 square times V sub 2. So we cancel pi over 4, so we have diameter 1 250 mm square times V1 equals 100 mm square times V sub 2. We don't need to express the diameter in meter because these two have the same units. Anyway, they can be canceled, the units. So V sub 2 is 6.25 of V sub 1. We then substitute into this equation. So pressure head at 1 equals 6.25 V1 quantity square over 2G minus V1 square over 2G. Simplifying, so pressure head at 1 in terms of oil equals 38.0625 V1 square over 2G. Then we sum up pressure from 0.1 down to this point. Then the pressure at this point is equal to this point, so we jump across. Then minus specific weight of mercury times Z equals the pressure here, which is 0. Then after we compute P1, substitute here, then we can solve the theoretical velocity at 1. So P sub 1 plus specific weight of oil times 0.9. So specific weight of oil is specific gravity of oil times specific weight of water, so times 0.9. Then we jump across to this point. So nothing changes in the equation. Then we rise minus 13.6 times 9.81 specific weight of mercury times z, which is 0.29 equals 0. Then equals 0. So from here we can solve for pressure at 1, and it is equal to 31.098 kilopascals. We then evaluate pressure head at 1 in terms of oil. So P1 over gamma of oil equals 31.098 over 0.86 times 9.81. So pressure head in terms of oil is equal to 3.5676 meters of oil. Substitute into this equation, 3.5676 equals 38.0625 times V1 square over 19.62. So V sub 1 theoretical is equal to 1.3561 meters per second. So Q theoretical therefore is area of the pipe, pi over 4.25 square times V1 1.3561. So Q theoretical is equal to 0.06657 cubic meters per second. Finally, we substitute Q sub T into this equation, and noting that C sub coefficient of discharge is C sub C, C sub V. So Q equals C sub C, C sub V times Q theoretical. So Q equals 0.98 times 0.06657. So actual discharge can now be computed, and it is equal to 0.04110 cubic meter per second. The diameter of the jet at the vena contracta, C sub C, is equal to area at the vena contracta over area of orifice. Area of the at the vena contracta is pi over 4 diameter of the jet at the vena contracta square, all over pi over 4 times 100 mm square. So cancel pi over 4, so C sub C equals, it reduces to diameter at the vena contracta square over diameter of orifice square. So substitute, 0.63 is equal to diameter at the vena contracta square over 100 square. So diameter at the vena contracta is in mm is equal to 79.37 mm. Then for the actual velocity of oil in the jet, that's the actual because it is the velocity of oil at the section, at the jet section, which is at the vena contracta. So Q actual equals area at the vena contracta times actual velocity, and the area at the vena contracta is coefficient of discharge times area, coefficient of contraction rather, times area of orifice, then times actual velocity or velocity of oil in the jet. So 0.04110 is equal to 0.63 times pi over 4.01 square times actual velocity. So actual velocity or velocity of the oil in the jet is 8.306 meters per second. Problem 91. Water flows in a vertical Venturi meter with inlet and throat diameters of 150 mm and 50 mm respectively. The vertical distance between the inlet and throat sections is 100 mm. If the differential gauge contains mercury with a deflection of 360 mm, determine the theoretical flow rate in liters per second. Also compute the actual discharge if the head loss is 180 mm of water. So for the solution, let's have the figure first to help analyze the situation, although I use the formula which I derived in the lecture part for Venturi meters for both the theoretical and actual discharge. So we have the inlet 150 mm, throat diameter 50 mm. It is vertical and the flowing liquid is water. So we will call this 0.1 at the inlet, then 0.2 at the throat. So this is Z, the deflection. Then this is denoted by Y. Don't mind the Y because it will be cancelled by experience. So the flowing fluid is water. Then we set up the general formula for theoretical discharge, and I hope that you can also derive it by your own so that you can remember the formula. Q theoretical equals pi over 4 times diameter 1, diameter at the inlet square, times diameter at the throat square, square root of 2g times small h all over quantity diameter at the inlet to the fort minus diameter at the throat to the fort. So that's the formula, and I hope that you can remember it. Then the expression for H is, it is the difference in pressure head and elevation head, that one, minus the pressure head and elevation head at point 2. And we can show later that it is in general quantity specific gravity of the manometer liquid, which is mercury in this case, divided by specific gravity of the flowing liquid or fluid, which is water, which is 1 minus 1 times Z. So if that's the case, it is 12.6 of Z, regardless of the orientation, whether the venturimeter is horizontal, inclined, or in this case, vertical. That's the formula for H, quantity specific gravity of manometer liquid over specific gravity of flowing liquid or fluid minus 1 times quantity Z, the deflection, which is in this case 0.36 meter or 360 mm. So since Z1 is 0 and Z2 is 0.1, so H is P sub 1 over gamma of water plus 0 minus quantity pressure head at 2 plus 0.1. So simplifying, it is pressure head at 1 minus pressure head at 2 minus 0.1. So that when you encounter the same problem, you can proceed directly to this formula here and note that H is specific quantity specific gravity of manometer liquid over specific gravity of flowing liquid or fluid minus 1 times Z. So sum up pressure from 1 to 2. So we have pressure at 1, we go down up to this point, plus specific weight of water times Y plus Z. We jump across to this point, these two points have the same pressure. Nothing changes in the equation, minus specific weight of manometer liquid, which is mercury, times Z, which is this now. Then minus from this point to that point, specific weight of water times quantity Y plus 0.1. And the pressure at this point is equal to the pressure at point 2. They are at the same level in a homogeneous fluid at rest, so equals P sub 2. Gamma of water Y minus gamma of water Y will be cancelled. So P sub 1 minus P sub 2 equals gamma of mercury times Z minus gamma of water times Z plus gamma of water times 0.1. So dividing everything by specific weight of water, P1 over specific weight of water minus P sub 2 over specific weight of water equals specific weight of mercury over specific weight of water minus 1 times Z. For these two terms, factor out Z, which is now this. Then specific weight of water over specific weight of water is 1 times 0.1, so we have 0.1 here. Transpose this to the left and take note that it is now this form here, which is H. So H equals P1 over specific weight of water minus P sub 2 over specific weight of water minus 0.1 equals specific gravity of mercury, because this is specific gravity of mercury, minus 1 times Z. So H is equal to quantity 13.6 minus 1 times Z. So that's why I mentioned earlier that for water mercury combination, it is 12.6 of Z, regardless of the orientation, horizontal, inclined, or vertical, such as this. That is H. The general formula is quantity specific gravity of flowing fluid, specific gravity of manometer fluid over specific gravity of flowing fluid, in this case water, which is 1, minus 1 quantity times C. So H therefore is 4.536 meters of water. Substitute here, Q theoretical equals pi over 4 times quantity 0.15 square times 0.0105 square, then times square root of 2g, 19.62, times h over 0.15 to the fourth minus 0.05 to the fourth. Then we multiply 1000 further to make the units liters per second. So Q theoretical is equal to 18.64 liters per second. For the actual discharge, same expressions here except that we replace h by h minus head lost, because the head lost is in the same side as this term. So if this is minus quantity, this term's here, so it is also minus head loss. So that's why, because this is h, then minus head loss. So q actual is pi over 4 diameter 1 square, diameter at the inlet square, times diameter at the throat square, square root of 2g quantity h minus head loss over diameter at the inlet to the fourth minus diameter at the throat to the fourth. Substituting, then multiply 1000 to change the units to liters per second from cubic meter per second. So pi over 4.15 square 0.05 square square root of 2g 19.62 times quantity 4.536 minus 0.18 over 0.15 to the fourth minus 0.05 to the fourth times 1000. So actual discharge is 18.27 liters per second.